the president's plan be what we need here in the area to boost the job force? Many are hoping so. 4029's Jo Ellison joins us now live in Fort Smith with our continuing team coverage tonight. Jo.
Well, you know, Craig, we're right here at Sweet Bay on Rogers Avenue in Fort Smith. Now, the TV tonight here, it'll carry the president's speech. Also, people, they'll be on their laptops. But they're not the only people that we talked to today. We went around the area talking to many people, and they're really going to be paying close attention to the president's speech tonight.
I will walk somebody's dog, you know, walk your kids, babysit your dog, whatever it takes. I laugh to keep from crying.
Athena Cook has been drawing unemployment for about 2 years while she brushed up on some skills at the Adult Education Center in Fort Smith.
My unemployment will run out the end of October. I have got to find a job.
That's why she'll be watching as the president unveils his job package to the world. Many are hoping President Obama's plan will be fresh rather than a rehash of infrastructure and construction jobs.
I need them to bring the jobs back in America.
At 52, Cook was laid off from Whirlpool.
I was let go due to salary workforce reduction.
Gary Udosh, the director of the center, will be watching too. He says around 2,000 students, with the biggest demographic being 25 to 44, could benefit from more training. He hopes the president's job package includes it.
I need computer skills. They need to go back and refresh on, you know, basic education, reading, writing, and math.
Cook says above all, she just wants hope.
I may look like it, but I'm not old enough to retire yet.
Now, what the president says tonight can mean so much to people right here in our area. Take a look at what those numbers are like. Now, according to the state, more than 4,000 people are currently unemployed in Sebastian County, more than 7,000 in Benton County, over 6,000 in Washington County, and over 2,000 in Crawford. Now, Craig, that's a rough estimate from the Department of Workforce Services, but a really good idea of how many people are affected right here in our area. Back to you.
4029's Jo Ellison reporting live tonight in Fort Smith.